By definition, mass is the quantity of matter that a body contains. But could there be negative mass? That seems counterintuitive, right? How can you have -2 kilograms of something? Negative mass seems to violate the laws of our universe. But in 2014, a couple of excited researchers did some calculations and found out it was actually A-OK. The universe is fine with negative mass, as long as that mass isn't a solid. If it's a fluid, you're cool. Science pun. So, negative mass can exist, according to their calculations. A perfect fluid, which doesn't exist, would allow negative mass to exist and wouldn't defy the laws of general relativity. I know that's complicated, but let's just put a pin in that for a second. Because just recently, in 2017, researchers used a superfluid to create something with, effectively, negative mass. In spite of what the media is saying, even actually in the university's own press release, the researchers never said they created negative mass. Instead, the actual paper says they created negative effective mass. What really happened, as I understand it, is they created a Bose-Einstein condensate that behaves unexpectedly, moving in a way that makes it seem like, or that is similar to, something with negative mass. But it doesn't actually have negative mass. Sidebar, this is actually a problem in science journalism. It's easy to get excited and miss a key detail. We've done it. Lots of people have done it. In science and in journalism, details matter. And this has been said by you in the comments, by other science communicators, and even John Oliver. But science is hard. End sidebar. With that in mind, again, this isn't negative mass. It's a Bose-Einstein condensate that behaves as if it had negative mass. As in, when this superfluid moves, it does so in an unexpected way. But the stuff does have mass. The superfluid was made of 10,000 rubidium-87 isotopes, so it has the mass of that. This all makes perfect sense, right? Totally. But come on, I know all of you nerds out there are nerds, but you didn't tune in to learn about how a trapped supercooled superfluid behaved weirdly. So let's just close the book on that. Now remember that pin? Let's go ahead and snag that back. What if they had created negative mass? What would that be like? What would it look like? All the what? To be honest, nobody really knows. Negative mass was first theorized by Einstein early in the last century while coming up with general relativity. A handful of essays published in the 1950s coined the idea of negative mass as the opposite to positive mass, which is kind of what we interact with every day. So scientifically, it's a relatively new concept. Some of the papers say something made of negative mass would probably still have momentum and be subject to some of the limits of physics, but would also likely violate Newton's third law of motion, the equal and opposite reaction one. If you pushed a weight made of negative mass, it would move toward you. But I read one 1986 article by John G. Kramer, a physics professor at the University of Washington, and he described it really well. Like this. Consider a pair of equal and opposite positive and negative masses placed close to each other. The negative mass is attracted to the positive mass, while the positive mass is repelled by the negative mass. Thus, the two masses will experience equal forces and accelerations in the same direction, in violation of Newton's third law, and the system of two will accelerate seemingly without limit. The negative mass will chase the positive mass with constant acceleration. In either scenario, shiz is getting weird. If you're being pedantic, negative mass would be impossible, because no mass equals no matter at all. But pedantry aside, what negative mass seems to mean is matter out of the constraints of one of the bonds of the universe. It makes sense that something like this would excite science journalists. I just hope next time we're a little more positive. Okay, I'll stop. The more we understand about particle physics, the better we're going to understand the universe itself. To that end, we do have a video about how black holes and gravitational waves can help us potentially find dark matter. You can watch it here. Does this video hurt your brain? Because it totally hurt my brain while I was making it. Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more Seeker, and thanks for watching.